Welcome to OpenBox Education. In this video, I'm going to explain about CAMP algorithm. So here, CAMP, C-A-M-P is nothing but Computer Aided Minimization Procedure. In this, I'm going to explain phase 1 of this algorithm. So here, this CAMP 1 minimizes single functions. So the function to be minimized is expressed as a sum of minterms. And these minterms are input to the program in their decimal designations. So let the function to be minimized to be the four variable function. So here the four variable function f3 is given as sum of the mean terms 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 10, 13, 14, and finally we have 15. So here this function is a four variable function. So here this four variable function is represented in the form of a k-map. So we'll discuss later about this k-map. So here this computer takes up the first mean term in the list 1. That is, within a given function, the computer takes that first mean term in the list. The first mean term is 1 and calculates its degree of adjacency. So for calculating that degree of adjacency for this mean term is converted into binary form, and each bit is complemented one at a time. So if you see here, we take that the mean term 1, and that will be converted into binary form. So 0001, this is the binary conversion of this mean term 1, and we'll complement each bit one at a time. So here the first variable A is there, we will complement this 0 to 1. So we got that 1001, so this will becomes to 9, and after that we'll complement this B bit. So here this will be, so here we'll get that 0101, we'll get this one, and next one we'll complement the C bit, so that we'll get 0011. So this becomes to 3, and we'll complement this D bit. So if we complement this one, we got that 0000. So here you got that 0 value. So here the degree of adjacency of this mean term 1 is given as 9, 5, 3, and 0. So here if you see this function, here there is no a 0 mean term. We have 1, 3, 5, and 9 mean terms are there within this degree of adjacency for the mean term 1. So in this process, the mean term generates all its adjacent mean terms one by one. So in this function, 9, 5, 3 are present, but 0 is absent. Hence, one has a degree of adjacency 3. That is, here the mean terms 9, 5, and 3. So 1, 2, and 3. So here, hence, one has the degree of adjacency 3 in this function, and its three directions of adjacency are 9, 5, and 3. So when 9 and 1 are combined, we get the product term from which a variable A is eliminated. That is, here if you see this one, the variable A is eliminated when the 1 and 9 are combined. So this will return by the replacing the bit under A by 2. That is, the variable which is eliminated, that will be written by 2. That is, the variable which is eliminated, that can be represented by 2. So thus we get a cube, that is 2001. So here we'll get that 2001 we will get. Similarly, when combines with the 5 and 3, the product terms are the cubes we will get as 0201 and 0021 are produced. So here this is the calculation of cubes by getting the adjacency of the mean term 1. So here for this 1, the degree of adjacency is 3. So it is therefore possible that the mean term 1 may be combined with other mean terms in the function and can be produced a cube from which all three variables corresponding to the three adjacency directions are eliminated. That is, here if the mean term 1 is combined with all the directions, then the mean terms A, B, C will be eliminated, so that where the variables are eliminated, that can be represented by 2. So the resulting cube of D, or we can get that 2, 2, 1. That is, here this A is eliminated, B is eliminated, and C is eliminated, so that in the place of these eliminated variables, we will place a 2. So we will get 2, 2, 2, 1, or the resulting cube is represented as only D. So the resulting cube can be represented as only D, or 2, 2, 2, 1. So this may be a solution cube for this minimization of the function f3. But whether this cube will really find a place in the final solution is not yet known. So hence this term, or this product term, is called as a candidate solution cube. Simply we can call it as a CSC. So the definition will go for this: a mean term m in the list of mean terms constituting a Boolean function f having a adjacency phi produces a candidate solution cube. So phi 2's in place of the variable that can be eliminated every time it combines with another mean term of the function. That is, simply we can say that when one product term is combined with another product term, in that product term the variable can be eliminated, and in the eliminated place we can place a 2. When two n variable mean terms combine, they produce a 1 cube of n minus 1 variables. That is, a variable can be eliminated simply. That is, for example, here we have a 4 variable mean term is there. Then when the 4 variable mean term is combined with the another mean term, then we'll get that the variables within that product term less than 4. That is why here representing n minus 1. That is, here we have n equal to 4, then n minus 1 is nothing but 3 variables. That is, we will get a cube less than n variable, that is n minus 1 variables. So hence it can easily be verified that an m cube from which m variables have been eliminated is the result of the combination of 2 to the power of m mean terms. That is, here 0 cube. So simply we can say that. So that is, here we have m cube is there, for example. So here m equal to 4. So from which m variable, that is 4 variables have been eliminated, is the result of the combination of 2 to the power of m. That is, for example, 2 to the power of 4. Then here we have m equal to 4. So 2 to the power of 4 equal to 16 mean terms. That is, within this mean term, all the elements are eliminated simply. So we can say that simply 0 cubes. So thus a 4 variable ABCD mean terms 1, 5, 9 and 13 produces a 2 variable product term, that is C dash D. That is, we can represent in the form of a 2 cube, that is 2, 2, 0, 1. So here C dash is nothing but 0 and D is nothing but 1. And the variables which are eliminated, those are represented by 2 and 2. So thank you very much for watching this video. To watch more videos, please subscribe to my channel Open Box Education. So here this is the CAMP algorithm phase 1. I explained here only the part 1, and the part 2 will be continued in my next video. So thank you very much.